time.
I mean, Team Dire can just watch while they take their axe. It's a really sad scenario to be in, but there's really nothing they can do. And Magnus is in big trouble. Magnus dead already. Troll died too.
Troll is dead. He came in from behind. You never want to come in from behind like that.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
That is a surprise. I mean, the game's over.
At this point, there's nothing they can do anymore.
Can they buy back and win? They have no buybacks. You just GG out.
It's annoying that Japan needs mana. They need to mana him.
You think ahead.
Yeah, exactly. They're going to Huskar again.
Obviously, two heroes here.
Jumping on the partner.
No Will-O-Wisp ready.
No Will-O-Wisp ready indeed. They still have the Oracle ult, however. So nobody should really be in danger of dying here. Time to spend.
Oh, 4 versus 5, it is not good.
Changing focus to the Oracle. Oracle has to ult himself. Very well done.
You can keep chasing her. PA is coming though. PA is coming in 5 seconds.
Double damage spend. This is a very hard fight for Raiden. They need to be careful.
Oh, PA is going to clean up here. Here we go.
No, PA can't clean up. You have to be so careful with PA right now.
Man up, PA.
No, don't man up.
Man up.
Okay, go to DK. Nice.
Man is still alive for 7 seconds. Can he live this?
And now it's time 3 seconds. Running.
3.
The Will-O-Wisp wins!
Oh, no, the stun on the Huskar.
Stun on the Huskar. Just run out. Just be out if you can. Can he make it? No,
the root.
Cancel. What canceled him?
The root from Oracle's Q.
Oh, no. And it's just
it's a disaster!
It might be team wipe.
Ehome is doing it!
Run! Oh,
it's
God.
A triple!
You know what? The two of them wanted to save the Huskar, so they also stayed behind.
No, but he's fine. He's gonna be fine, I think.
The Brink Dagger, not max range though. He's
nice.
Fine.
The curtain fight saved them!
Yeah, if there was a crit, he would have been dead.
Very questionable place there by Pugna.
And I crit!
Oh, the crits!
He's critting a lot.
You want to dive here? I would want to dive here. They got Oracle ult. Oracle ult is ready. Here we go.
Triple breaking wall. DK falling off. Getting back to safety in the fountain though. Just barely.
Look at that. The Oracle ult up. PA is going to kill everyone. It's time though.
The Will-O-Wisp! Oh. Three heroes again. Trying to focus it down. They can't
the
focus
dagger.
It. Oh my god.
Beautiful.
And now stun on the Tusk. And this will all but seal it. We're just waiting for the official confirmation now. Diving the fountain, they really want to get this kill.
There's no evasion anymore. On this true strike, look, he's gonna die.
He's alive. Alright,
capital GG, can you read into that? What does it mean?
Four, our juggernaut can get really big. Mm-hmm. The other one is, what if I go like a hybrid thing? Yasha also increases farming speed, but also makes me a strong fighter. And then I can keep up with the pace of my
team. They've already found their target. Yep. It's going to be Seb. He had no way to survive this. Space Boy is jumping in. He's got time dilation on 4 heroes, but there's no Chrono Spirit into the Omni Slash. Juggernaut can do the work. Supernova in a great position, but there's no one else to protect it. Not enough of the Fire Spirits out. So buyback comes in. Snowball as well, going towards Thompson as Jokam. He'll be there. Nortel giving the life through the Sun Ray, but it's also not enough. And then sealed up. There's going to be a dieback. OG are falling apart. The seams shard blocked up. Even Jiras cannot escape. No way out. They're all dead. And OG even bought back during that fight on the Fiend.
Of course. Does hit very hard with that God Strength activated. And that attack speed helps out a lot. So he has two good allies to use that on. It's very nice. A lot of the time people, at least in the past, from
thinking, careful.
Oh,
Jirax, she did not want to go up there. Thompson's nearby. Jirax is actually surviving a decent amount of time, but not long enough. They toss back down Thompson, but Seb will arrive with a Storm Bolt, so Tiny stunned up, still on the retreat. There's a lot of players from Boom ID potentially ready to fight, and they're able to do so. Laguna Blade, heavy damage. Albert faces Boy, jumps forward. He hits the Tomb, then Chrono. Tiny together, they'll be pulled in by the shards. So both players down as you move further to the north. Jirax, get another Rolling Boulder down and actually over towards the Tusker, kicking him up the hill, away from Thompson. Maybe not a full part of the plan, as Faceless Void has now finally gone down. But watch that Omni Slash, watch that bounce back out again. Juggernaut's managed to retreat down south, while the Tusker has finally fallen.
He got the jump
right over on top of the Lina, looking for the Chrono Sphere. There is no target. Everyone's too grouped up together, and Tani's done out in the back line. Jirax, he's just made the job of holding out the rock. Spin is down, but this is an Aghanim Scepter Phoenix. You know it takes so much to get through the egg, and they're unable to do it, which means Thompson has all the time to steal the damage to really win the game. Boom ID is still putting up a fight, but Lina finally punched down by the Earth Spirit. G-Rex will rolling boulder down, lands another stun, and actually gets himself a double kill for his efforts. Tiny tries to do as much as he can. G-Rex, they just tank through this. Warcry buff up, they have the shields, the Lotus Orb will not protect enough, and maybe that Boom Idea she has enough here. Thompson, he's already consumed the cheese, looks to steal more of the damage and able to do so. Hold the Juggernaut inside the Chronosphere, even the Sunray burning Tiny on the other side of time and space. Seth gets the double stun out, Boom ID, the reinforcements wanted to come in, but it was stopped in the tracks, and OG will take game one.
Tough. He's playing against four strength heroes, and they can't deal with him.
Omni Slash just dodges the ship, at least there's a little less damage coming into him, but getting rid of the Silent Stick, but now into spin as well, under the tier 1 tower. It's a little too easy for ILTV. But I'm watching the mid. RP is up. Sev is looking for his own opportunity. May want a little bit of help, and here it comes inside the Timberstorm. Okay, just continuously stunned. The ET Splitter will be able to clamp both of them down. The RP to catch out too, and then G-Rex combines it together. The double silence. Everyone's fates are connected. And that is Tiny ET down. Conker's already gone, and it looks like IO is going to end up in the same position. G-Rex with the triple kill. Thompson even making sure he can survive by taking the aggro of the tower. They got enough to get through the Timbersaw. The ET stomp is out, but Seven no tell. They got around the back. Timbersaw able to chain himself out of it. And this is not the fight they were looking for. Not to mention Tiny's in the back line. Thompson took a lot of damage, but not enough to kill him. Maybe Ego can finish that job. Finally, the Tiny will fall. Thompson swapped up and away from the fight. He couldn't stay on top of him. And swap again. You just get interrupted. The Chrono is huge. Same with the Color Blast right over the top of him. And a secondary one. That one won't do as much damage. The ET Splitter. ILTV couldn't get away in time, but they are now on the chase. OG, they smell blood in the water. The stomp, it will not create enough space from Destiny. He runs down, but the damage from the VS is so high, they'll curse up the Keeper of the Light just to hold him in position so they can finish the job. Four heroes down from E-Home. He's already taken care of the mid-racks, so he comes over to be involved in the engagement. Notel once again, God Strength now up, trying to beat that frontliner. He wants him to go on him, and that's where the curse comes in. Over on the Tiny, swap him out, and the Chronosphere in the back line, it does actually catch out Beastmaster. He will not be able to get the roar off, or will he? He's surviving so long. No, the roar will not come off. Thompson, Manda again trying to dodge, but failing to dodge that ET Stomp, but it may not matter if Ego can't get back into relative safety. Another quick silence. This one's over on the ET. The Avalanche with the extra stuns, it's buying some more time, but not enough. Down goes the ET. Beastmaster still the only one down. The OG, they're trying to get the Megas up. Or, I should say, in their favor. Jump in, Faith Beyond. He has no Chronosphere, so he's the next best thing for him, which is time dilation. But the stuns, the ball is out. There's three heroes caught in this. OG, they're in a rough spot and they can't get back out. So BS using that BKB. I think he actually ended up getting it from the side, but now they just keep bouncing in. Is there more damage? Thompson pushes them away. That Avalanche didn't keep the Chain Suns going, but that's why they have more of them. So much more of them. Thompson will finally fall. Wyvern should go down as well. Colin Brace is not protected from the Chakram. And then VS will join them in the afterlife. All five players from OG are down. Two have buyback, but E-Home are in recovery mode.
This, obviously, Klinks nowadays doesn't have all that extra health from Death Pact. You don't have that spell anymore.
Fionn comes in, gets the Avalanche tossing back over on Sven, but then he gets the double Storm Ball stun, not to mention the silence on Tiny. Doesn't really have a lot of mana. Firewind is spin-on-spin action. Thompson versus the Rubik. Up he goes. Thompson will still end up going down into the Omni Slash. They're being kept alive, but now bounced down. Wasn't enough from the False Promise. It's now ILTV trying to back out. The Huskar will survive, leaping himself forward. G-Rex, he cannot repel that kind of firepower, literally from the heart of Huskar.
Proving to be a problem for them to bring down when he has this Blade Fury stolen, so.
Jump in from Faith Beyond, at least there's a Soulbind double silence, but I don't know if that's going to be enough to save G-Rex. Notel comes in for the Storm Ball too. I'll be chained across the boat, but at the instant same time, steal. Rubik, Mr. Blink Dagger now up. He's got that maneuverability, but Juggernaut, he actually looked towards the top lane. ILTV is trying to do a counter push against E-Home push.
He
is nowhere near fast enough for this, but without Grimstroke, without that Soulbind combination of abilities, do you even have enough? to stop this push coming in.
Just kill him instead, right?
Yeah, that'll work. But then is there a fight to be had back at base? Juggernaut's going to fly in and he's TPing straight towards the front lines. They want this kill. They're going to look towards Husker. A push back, but the Omni Slash up. Damn, he tanks through so much. It's the false promise of innocence. He got it off once again. A quick jump forward. They'll move back out. Oracle's already down. Husker, how much life have you got? More than enough to survive. And the stomp, it'll catch two. Thompson needs to change his target over towards the Husker and kill him off. But again, they push him back in ASD's in and the Avalanche. How many times must this never-ending stun continue? Even a spin from ASD, he'll jump in the middle of fight, killing off No-Tail. You've already lost your clinks. You don't have your damage. You've lost everybody. Buy back all you want. I don't think it's going to be enough as Faith Beyond keeps the fight going underneath their own Observer Ward. This is OG falling apart at the seams.
Nope.
Another fight going on. They went deep. There's the Mystic Flare coming down. Furby trying to dodge out the Mischief, but not this time. They say no. They try to bat away, but too late. Magnetize being used, but it's more defensive than anything else. Yokam just trying to distract them, get their attention. FBZ trying to run down with his creeps on the side on the sword. He surges them forward. That is doing a lot. Shallow Grave keeps Yokam alive, trying to fight up against it so the TA can arrive. And from the low ground to the high ground, the missed chances will not stop you from getting that kill. He knew he was dead, but he wanted to make sure someone was coming with him. FBZ looking to go again. Faker going for TP away. They haven't got the vacuum available. They don't need it. The melt damage from Makoto is too much. Taro runs for the high hills. He says, great. They found our stacks, guys.
They're not touching Medusa in the fight. And Medusa deals a lot of damage. Using Mystic Snake a couple of times. She even has a Mask of Madness.
Yeah, but this Darkseid is just throwing her up perfectly. Like, they don't need to touch her. But this is more torturous, Lacoste. You sit there and watch your creeps be taken. Your farm. Your rightly earned gold is just snatched from your jaws.
Yeah, I'm glad the Templar Assassin brought Gesso as
Taro,
first item.
The one keeps him alive. Mystic Flare's there. TA's going to go down the Roland from Yokam just to get close enough. Now they move through. Vengeance must be had and do so. She should be going down. The Boundless Strike gets the final touch and now they're going to turn around. Sansa is out. The Shallow Grave is there as well. Darkseid keeps moving forward. Wukong's comes down and Sword. He can't run quick enough. He knows he's dead on the side. Axel's going to go for the stomp, but interrupted by the vacuum. He'll fall as well. The roll through. We'll call it zoning rolls. He still hasn't missed a single one that matters. So they're going to have to actually look for some sort of scouting mission to just get vision around that pit in preparation. Because they have got a decent combo when they go into a pit fight, right?
Yeah, they do. But they don't know what's happening on the other side of the river. And no one was showing from Boom ID. There it
is. Oh, moving in Makoto. Oh no, Skywrath. The second tap is enough. 70 seconds of silence. Stun's going to come out. Trying to turn around the Earth Spirit, but he's going to be forced up the way. He's going to be fine. And that was the gaze used. Now they need to retreat. Katara needs to be careful. The vacuum connects on the free. And there's the wall as well. The Wukong's is going down. The Earth Splitter free will not matter. You're losing too many heroes. Katara's going to fall as well. Baker will make his escape, but you've lost your Deucer. Full retreat, they say. Axel trying to get out. There we go. The tree's going to be cut through by the Timber Sword. Should cover their escape, but no, it's too late. Earth Spirit is down. Deucer forced to buy back. This is do or die as Boom enter the base again. Nice cut the tree, but Faker, what do you do next? You might die. Boundless Strike interrupts the Timber Chain away. He's going to have the Ghost Step to protect himself. The Bat back. They say if you kill Deucer, this is all over. She can't even fight back because of the disarm. She's going to try now, but it's too late. They're going to lose them all. And no, game one goes away. I think this is where they look to break base. They've got the Stampede available. There's nothing really stopping them from going high ground right now. Oh, the stomp coming out of two. They actually catch them out here. Now in trouble. Warfling looking to get back involved in the fight. He's going to have to get across quick because Rubik's already down. It looks like Shakira's going to fall as well as Darkseid. He's running him down, but slowly eventually they will fall. Cyclone's coming out, final little bit of time, the buyback's going to be there from the Jakira, but can he do enough? FBZ, he gets out of the base, and Makoto needs to be careful here. He might have a DD, and he might have an Aegis, but he doesn't want to expend it for nothing. Ice Path's going to be there, and they follow this up and finish him off. Nice Strike of Fate to slow things down. Sword, he hasn't got a split anymore, he needs to back away, but the Warcry comes out, Makoto with this spell to get in there quick enough, and on the back line, you see Katara just get melted through by the Centaur and the Grimstrike. Sword might survive, but you lose the most important part of your draft as Morphling is down again for another 40 seconds.
Everyone is alive. Oracle still has ulti. They have Aegis.
Faker. Oh no, Faker, not like this. One more click. He doesn't even
need
it.
Back.
He's gone. The vacuum's going to be there. But what does it really achieve? Panthera stunned on the spot. This is not a tanky Darkseid. This is a melee support Darkseid. And he feels like it. My bad announce, but it's too late. Soulbind connects onto two. Axel will be the next to go down the Phantom Race. Just connects across onto the Brewmaster as well. It's going to be a team wipe as KezQ gets himself a triple kill. Got disarmed, stats resistance is nice. FBZ just trying to fakie him out here, but that's gonna be Megas.
Cooldown coming out. Fervin, can they room in place? He needs to escape this very fast. There's a snowball to save his life. Brian Roar comes out and tops him, but there we go. He uses the Battle Trance, just his spell straight away, turns around, gets himself two kills. FBZ on the back with the BKB activated, but still no chrono to work with. No tail. He's just trying to keep Jarex alive. They're going to turn around and try and punish him for that greed of trying to save his fellow support. Makoto moving through the buybacks on the table. Boom, are investing everything they need to. LTV trying to escape the shards, block him off, perfectly placed for the disarm out once more. Thompson, what the hell do I care? This status resistance is glorious. Walrus Punch going to be down a set, but he's so tanky. BKB use Keski will go down. Makoto trying to just get away from this, but he can't. He's out of leaps once more. They'll run him down. They'll turn around. They'll clean up the side of Boom, and it looks like OG may have just taken game one.
Give this man a rampage. GG's called.
Where's the rampage for the gyro without an iron? I'm sorry, we can't. Timber's too tanky.
Oh, he steals a rampage.
He stole it? Oh, Toxin.